coming up for a few minutes and we'll wait for these people to show up. Everybody tune. Let's do percussion here at the top.
Hi, I'm Mike Repper. I'm the music director of the New York Youth Symphony.
I'm really excited that you're all here. I know that you're excited as well. I'm stoked. This is a big, big moment for the New York Youth Symphony. It's New York Youth Symphony's first studio album.
There was a lot of thought and energy that went into what would make a very special project that the New York Youth Symphony could accomplish during the difficult time that we're going through worldwide. Obviously, you know, when everything was breaking down in March of 2020, we really didn't know what was going to be possible, what's not going to be possible, and we took a very long time to create a really unique project that is actually a debut for the New York Youth Symphony. Our very first studio album. We have to do it differently than normal. Normally we would be able to have the entire group in the room together. Now we have to do it distanced, we have to do it, you know, separated and things like that, but it's a really good experience for our students to get comfortable with recording and getting an excellent educational experience.
When we were thinking about what we could do in the midst of this pandemic, recording was like the number one thing. It's an important skill for our students to learn as the next generation. This digital moment is going to be forever.
One of the pieces that we're playing is called Umoja, and that's by Valerie Coleman. And Umoja means unity. And I can't think of a better piece to sort of bring us all together in this time, even though we have to play separated.
Started this whole process in the summertime, even discussing the whole thing. And there was, you know, Zoom calls and discussing how we might actually do this and make it work during this time, during the pandemic. Because it's very different to how you record an orchestral album. So we're breaking things up and recording groups separately to be able to, you know, make sure we don't have too many people in the room.
So for violinists, what you're gonna wanna do, you're gonna wanna wear the cord on your left side.
The biggest challenge is that the whole orchestra will never be in the same room at the same time. First we recorded the strings, and then we threw together sort of a scratch track that the winds could play against, the winds and percussion. So they are hearing the strings. The strings have never heard the winds. They're going to be very surprised when they hear the whole thing.
After being in quarantine because of the pandemic for so long, you kind of forget what it's like to play with other people in person. So coming in to record this album has really reminded me not to take music for granted.
One of the pieces that we're going to be playing is Ethiopia's Shadow in America by Florence Price. It's one of my favorite pieces by Florence Price, and regretfully, there isn't a studio album recording of it by an American orchestra, so I'm really excited to be making the very first one. We're also going to be performing Florence Price's Piano Concerto, which is a really excellent piece, and actually the edition that you're going to be hearing on this album is brand new. It's Florence Price's newly found original orchestration.
I always thought growing up that people that looked like me in the 19th and 20th centuries just weren't a part of the classical composition sphere. So I love learning about Florence Price and her works, including the Piano Concerto, which we recorded, and having that previous mindset being proved wrong while playing a piece composed by someone who looks like me for the first time.
I was introduced to the Florence Price Concerto in 2016. This whole experience recording the concerto, it has been so exhilarating. I'm so impressed with the work that has been put in by the New York Youth Symphony, by their wonderful conductor, Michael. Just everyone has really taken this so seriously, and it means so much. And I am so incredibly excited. I can't imagine what it's going to be like to sit there and hear the final product. And for the first time, be able to hear myself playing this piece that I love so much, that means so much to me, at such a high level. I really look forward to it.
The final piece that we're going to be playing is a piece by New York Youth Symphony alum Jesse Montgomery called Soul Force.
I really admire Montgomery's creative instrumentation in this piece. I think her utilization of brass and percussion allows her to create a great range of sound and colors that is really uncommon among most orchestral repertoire.
To be able to rehearse and record in person is really meaningful because, especially during this pandemic, there are not many opportunities for musicians to get out there and perform with their friends. So I think it's really nice to be able to have this opportunity.
My hope for this project is one, to provide, first and foremost, the most amazing learning experience for our students that we can, especially in the midst of this pandemic. Secondly, I think team-wise, team-building-wise, for the New York Youth Symphony community, this is incredible. We have truly rallied all of our staff, our artistic staff, our faculty, our parents, our board, around this. It's providing a sense of hope and light in an otherwise very dark moment. And I'm so proud of everybody coming together around this. I wish we could have all of us together at Carnegie Hall like usual. But in the absence of that, this is the most amazing thing we could have done, and I'm so excited about it.